Did you know that the top 300 Azure customers all use Azure Policy? They use it to ensure their subscriptions and resources stay compliant with corporate and external standards. Guillermo Gomez is here to show us the latest updates to Azure Policy today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Guillermo, and he's going to show us the latest updates to Azure Policy. So why Azure Policy?
Well, customers that are moving to the cloud have had the challenge that things are different than when they were on-prem, right? On-prem, they had the model where they had kind of the gatekeeper. Normally, it's the central IT team, and that team is responsible for getting the users resources that they want, right? So a user will go and say, hey, Mr. Central IT, give me this. They can control all the governance, and that's it, right? But now, when they move to the cloud, things are slightly different, right? Customers now, or users, are actually having access to the cloud directly. And that makes a challenge for the team that is in charge of making sure that the right things and the right governance is in place. So how do you do that? They do it normally through external documentation. That could be like tens or hundreds of pages or documents that they go to the developer and say, hey, Mr. Developer, go ahead and build an environment based on this. That's difficult for the developer, right? So if you can have all those controls in the cloud, things are going to move fast while making sure that you have the right controls. And in here, we've already talked in previous episodes about blueprints, and today we're going to focus on the latest on policy.
Got it. So this is going to combine the self-service power of the cloud, but yet not sacrifice any of the security and compliance that we want
there
on those resources.
There you go. Perfect. We want to make sure that customers are still having that speed and that agility while making sure that the right guardrails are in place.
Perfect.
So the very first thing that I want to show you, and as you said, right, 300 out of our top 300 customers are using policy, and we've learned a lot from that. So we are adding a lot of things based on what our customers really want. So the first thing I'm going to show you, that we have the concept of initiative. An initiative is a set of policies that accomplish a single goal. In this case, this one is for tagging, and we just want to make sure that all resources are tagged properly. One of the use cases is cost management, right? So let's see while this loads.
So this is making sure that almost every resource, and I believe maybe it is every resource inside of Azure, has the ability for you to tag it with different metadata that you're wanting to apply. And a lot of people use that data to know which cost center needs to be charged for that particular resource. And
Correct.
What you're doing here is now saying, has everything been tagged and tagged appropriately?
Correct, right, because you can have multiple tags in multiple resource. Best practices say that you should have all your resources tagged for different purposes, and the one that I want to show you is cost management. In this case, we have a policy that enforces the cost management tag into a resource. And what customers want is to make sure that they understand what are the changes made by policy, right? Because we have different types of policy. We have audit, which just basically logs all the events but don't restrict anything. But then we have enforcing that makes sure that that happens like that, that is setting those guardrails. And then we have remediation, which means that if something is not correct, let's make sure that policy gets it correct.
Got it.
Right. So one thing that our customers want to see is why is this thing non-compliant? In this case, we click on view non-compliance reasons, and in here we can see that the reason for non-compliance is current value must exist, the field code is the cost code that is the part of the tag that needs to exist, and nothing exists. So customers can see why a policy is not, or why a resource is not compliant against which policy, which
right.
is
Right, and this
thing.
Also gives you some remediation steps, right? If you do what this is telling us to do, then you're going to be able to pass this.
There you go, because even though we have remediation capabilities, when customers move to the cloud, normally they don't do governance from the beginning, right? That's something that just happens. You go to the cloud, you're excited, and you get going. But governance is something that you need to get back. So this is one thing that helps you through that.
Okay.
So that's one thing, and then the other thing that I wanted to show you is change history, right? What are these changes that have been made by policy?
So these are changes that were made to the resource for us, or changes to the policies that we're trying to enforce upon our resources?
Change to the resource by policy.
Oh,
so,
okay.
As I said, if you have a remediation policy, probably.
Gotcha. That one will actually take actions on your behalf.
So in this case, I just went into the resource called AA Contoso. Now while it's loading, it will give you a little more information, but what I'm interested on in the change history is a preview feature that we released around February timeframe. And in here, you can select the timeframe, right? So you have like the last hour, 1 day, 7 days, 14 days. In this case, conveniently, I have one change made yesterday for this demo. And it gives you in simple JSON what are the changes, right? You see in red what are the areas that have been deleted, and in green what are the areas that have been added. In this case, data classification area has been removed, and we have a cost code.
Gotcha.
Now, this is helping you, as I said, know what has been changed by policy. Mm-hmm. It gives you more visibility into that as a cloud custodian. All right, great. Now, one of the things that we have announced, and at the beginning of this week, we announced policy for AKS, right? Policy mm-hmm. allows you to create policies for every service that is exposed to ARM. But if you want to go deeper than that, that's a different story. So we've released the capability to go deeper than that for Key Vault and for AKS. In this case, I'm going to show you how it works for AKS. One of the things that you can do for Key Vault is make sure that the right certificates and keys are in place. Before, you couldn't do it with policy. Now you can. And I'm just going to show you how there is a policy that is actually making sure that that is auditing that there are new self-signed certificates, right? So this is just showing you how you can go deeper into Key Vault. You can do the same thing in AKS. In AKS, you can go inside the cluster and check pods, check namespaces, or ingress. So
okay.
That's a brand new feature that we released. If you see here, we just check the audit new self-service certificates. We have three resources that are non-compliant inside Key Vault, and you can go ahead and just get more details around that. Here you can see everything that is going on inside what is compliant versus what is not compliant.
Okay.
So this is just showing how we are continuously evolving to get policy to go deeper and deeper into Azure. The next thing that I want to show you is ingest policy, right? So as I've said, this is another area where you can go deeper into a single resource. In this case, you could do things for VMs like, hey, I have a VM and I'm a US company and I want to make sure that all the VMs are created in the US and not in another region.
Okay.
That's what you could do. But what happens if you want to see what happens inside that VM? That's what we're doing here with ingest policy. And we have a bunch of built-in policies here. Actually, these are initiatives, so a set of policies that are accomplishing
okay.
a specific goal. So there are a lot of things like, I want to make sure that certificates are not expired. That's one of the most common things that happen. You can go ahead and create a policy that tracks that, sends you an alert if you say, hey, in 30 days, a certificate hasn't been updated or not. In this case, I'm just going to show you how to create one to make sure that passwords are secure.
Okay.
That's something that you would do inside a VM. And it's fairly straightforward. I'm going to use the default settings here. So I'm going to assign this initiative. I'm going to choose a scope. So the scope, you could do not right now management groups, or you could do a subscription. In this case, I'm going to choose our demo subscription. And I'm going to leave everything as a default in this case. For example, in the one that I told you about certificates, it will give you the option to see how many days in advance you want to be alerted, 30 days, 60 days, whatever you need. So the whole goal of this is to make sure that the right policies are in place so you don't get an error, so you get alerted and there's no errors in the future because you are proactive and fixing them. Now, I want to show you how that looks. So if I go here and I type password. Actually, I don't have one here, so let's go to the certificate one that I know that I have created.
And these, what I'm doing now is I'm going through the catalog of policies and initiatives, and then I assign them to the resources that I want that to be applied to.
Yeah, and the scope is there, the subscription or the management group. Every resource under that scope is what will get audited in this case. So in here, I see that, you know, for the one for certificates that I mentioned, right? I created one for passwords, but the one that I have deployed is for certificates. I know that there is something that is not compliant. I can click on it, and I can get more information about that. I go into the resource. I can see the resource itself. I'm just drilling down inside the resource, and when you go here, it will tell you what is the issue here. In this case, the monitoring agent certificate is about to expire in less than 30 days. Now I know. Now I can change it. I'm avoiding a possible problem.
Okay, got it.
And lastly, one of the questions that we're getting by customers is like, hey, to create policies in a specific services, I need to know the aliases for that service, right? How do I know that? So we have an auto-generation feature of aliases. In this case, I have it preloaded, but I'm going to show you how to get the aliases for SQL. This is just the line of code that I'm putting into the CLI to be able to show that, and you can get all those aliases. There are a lot, right? So if customers need to get access to those aliases, they can get it. And all of that is in our policy documentation.
So again, tell me, why do I need these aliases again?
So yeah, the alias is something, in order to create a policy, you need to have like certain aliases for each service, right? You need to say, hey, because each service has a bunch of features, and you can create a bunch of different policies for that service, right? So the aliases are what is needed in order to create a policy for that specific feature on that service.
Okay, so this is like the unique identifier that allows me to assign it to that particular policy. Okay, correct. And then the way that you list that is just using the Azure CLI.
Yeah.
Got it.
Correct.
Okay.
And that's the latest on Azure Policy.
Oh, this is awesome. Thank you so much for showing us all this stuff. And it's, I meet a lot of our customers when I'm in the field, and this is something that's really top of mind. So it's great to see that we're continuing to invest and make it easier for them to do the right thing, because the cloud is such a powerful platform, and you don't want to slow them down with a lot of policy that's manual, and this is making it all a lot more
automatic
for us.
In fact, this is something that for one audience that is not the typical audience, which is developers, right? It enables developers because it's integrated with Azure DevOps. So let's say that a developer is deploying some code, and you know, at the time of deployment, policy kicks in and may tell you, hey, there is something wrong. That's something that enables developers to, hey, I'm not going to go through an approval process. I can use this when it kicks in. Then let's say that it's compliant, then it can go straight to production. Or if not, it will get the workflow back.
Nice.
So the developer can make the change. And then whenever it passes the compliance process, it will go through.
Great.
So that's something.
Yeah, so you're shifting left that ability to get quick alerts that you don't have to deploy into Azure to find out you're in violation. You can actually find out in your pipeline as
there
well.
There you go.
That's awesome. Yeah. We are learning all about the new improvements to Azure Policy here on Azure Friday.